Drug discovery is a very long and difficult process, and when you do actually get something to the end and it's actually making a difference, it just motivates you to do it again and again and again. And I think our employees all see the impact of this product in particular on patients, and it just inspires them just to keep going. Zepatier is a combination of two direct-acting antiviral small molecule drugs. They act directly to inhibit viral replication, so the replication of HCV, which then allows the immune system to clear the virus and then ultimately to cure the patient of the disease. But the existing treatments for HCV were based on interferon, but many patients that take interferon don't complete their treatment because it's so poorly tolerated. But you can imagine feeling like you have the flu for a year. HCV is a virus that replicates very rapidly and resistance develops very quickly. So we were looking to come up with a regimen that would be shorter duration, much better tolerated by the patients, and active broadly against all genotypes and resistance-associated variants. About 10 years ago, with the first generation protease inhibitors and then with the discovery of NS5A inhibitors, it became pretty clear, it was pretty exciting, that we could actually potentially cure the disease without interferon. The initial compounds that were discovered across the industry were not broadly active, were not potent enough. You're having to design a drug that almost acts like, you know, maybe 10 or 15 drugs, because each variant and genotype expresses a slightly different form of these proteins, and the drug now has to be active against each one. We had lots of ideas on which compounds to make. The problem was is how to make them quick enough. So for me, it was the innovations in synthetic chemistry that really allowed us to move quickly to test all of our hypotheses as quickly as possible. As we experimented with different ways to make these compounds, it led us to actually think about different compounds to make. That seems a little convoluted, but it is actually a form of serendipity, in that now we're thinking about biological data guiding our designs and guiding us which compounds to make. But now we're also saying, huh, if you change the chemical synthesis, that also now gives us access to different compounds that we should make and test that were not necessarily that obvious from the biological data. And it was actually some of this serendipity that led us to both of these compounds. We would not have made these compounds if we'd not changed the way we were approaching the chemical synthesis. What was great about the event last night was bringing that team together again. Many of those folks are not at Merck anymore. They've gone to do other things. So it was great to just have the entire group come back together and celebrate what was, you know, 10, 15 years of work. All of the chemists at our company really want to be part of the club, the heroes. The most motivating thing about this is seeing the impact that the Heroes Award has on all of the other chemists in the company, because they now go back to their programs and it just inspires them to keep going, to try to get their program to be a success, so one day they could actually be nominated for the ACS Heroes. Our company has had, I think, three teams that are heroes. We'd like to have a few more.